Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about extraction biomechanics. When did you decide to take out 4's versus 5's? And if you are a general dentist, you are hopefully not taking out premolars. You're going to get mad if you are. Hopefully you are not taking out premolars on kids or anyone under age 18 because it's probably not necessary. We're talking about adults who have declined jaw surgery. This is what we're talking about. So these are compromised cases. And I want to reiterate this. This is not normal to take out teeth. It was 30, 40, 50 years ago. It is not now. It is not necessary. It can affect the airway. It can affect the profile. I don't like it, but y'all are asking about it. And sometimes in certain situations, it makes sense. Very, very, very limited situations. So I will be nice and make this video upon request of one doctor today who asked me to make this video. I have other extraction videos, again, not too many because it's not something I think is great. So I try to limit my education on this topic. But if you want to see my other extraction videos, you can go into my YouTube channel, Straight Smile Solutions. Put that in your search bar. It takes you to my YouTube channel, which has a green banner. Once you're there, find the itty bitty magnifying glass in the top right area, not corner, but top right of the kind of tabs, and put in extraction, and it should tell you all my videos on premolar extractions that I've made. But today we're specifically making one, and when do you know to take out 4's versus 5's? Okay, so let's go over what 4's and 5's are. So 4's are your first bicuspids. 5's are your second bicuspids. Average patient, if you're counting teeth, let's say we have all of our 8 teeth in each quad, you start with your 1's, which is your first incisor, your 2's are your lateral, your 3's are your canine, your 4's are your first bicuspid, your 5's are your second bicuspid, your 6's are your first molar, 7's are your second molar, 8's often are out, that's your third molar or your wisdom teeth. That's what we mean. This is the Palmer numbering system, where how international people refer to it, orthodontists refer to it, and general dentists in the US are weird. We do our own thing. So I speak 3 different numerical languages depending on who I'm talking to. If I'm talking to a general dentist from the US, an orthodontist from the US, or an international doctor, 3 different ways of talking. My mind is constantly translating during the day because I know where my doctors are from. I have doctors, international doctors, I have US doctors. Phew, it's a lot of work. Anyways, so I would say normally there's so many things you have to take into account, right? So first of all, like I said, I don't do extractions on kids. So a lot of times adults have compromised teeth. They have teeth with perio or root issues or endo issues or restorative issues. So first thing I'm gonna look at when I'm deciding 4's versus 5's is, are the teeth all healthy? You know, are the gums healthy? If one is bad and has, you know, a root canal, a post, a pin, and perio, I'm gonna take that one out versus the healthy virgin one, right? I don't care. Even if it's the mechanics are harder, I don't care. I'm gonna take that one out, right? Let's say they're both virgin teeth and they're both healthy. Okay, now we have to think about the mechanics, what makes sense. So in a class 1 severe crowding patient, okay, they've declined jaw surgery, they just want straight teeth, they know it might compromise their airway, they know it might compromise their profile, you have had the right informed consent, not your regular informed consent, but supplemental informed consent signed saying that this is compromised, saying this and that. Fine. You done all that? Fine. Patient is allowed to make their own decision. They're allowed to make their own decision as long as they've had their risks, benefits, and alternatives explained. You've done all that. Okay. Now I'm going to let you take out teeth. 4's versus 5's. On a class 1 crowded patient, you usually, first thing I do is look at the profile. Okay. And I'm like, okay, how badly will this mess up the profile if I take out 4's versus 5's? If they have like a super full Biomax profile, lips are like, boop, you know, okay, we're gonna take out 4's then, right? Or if their crowding is all anterior, meaning 3-to-3 crowding, and the back teeth are straight, we're gonna take out 4's because we wanna take out the teeth closest to the area of concern, be it the profile, the crowding, whatever. If we want to impact their profile less, and or if we have, say, some impacted second molars or things going on more towards the back, then we might take out 5's, right? That's in a class 1 crowding case. Now, what if we have a class 2 crowding case? Now, if it's a severe class 2 full step crowding case with major overjet, not so much issues on the lower, then we're only going to take out upper 4's or 5's, depending on what I told you about before, okay? Usually 4's. You might have to also put in some internal anchorage, be it TADS or a TPA or a NATS for that kind of case. If it is a slight class 2 case, slate class two, like half step. Then we're going to do the class two extraction pattern again, taking all those other issues into account, perios, restoratives, endos, everything's virgin. Half step, slate class two, not full class two. There are two extraction patterns I normally will do. And in that case, it is going to be upper 4's, lower 5's, or if it's very little class two, but has very crowded lower incisors, I might do upper 4's, lower incisor. So those are my two patterns for that situation. Now let's do the flip side, slight class three, okay? Slight class three with a ton of crowding, just slight class three. I'm talking like 1-2 millimeters, okay? Maybe three. I'm either going to take out it's gonna be the reverse, the inverse of what we just discussed in the class two. It's going to be upper 5's, lower 4's, okay? Or it could be upper 5's, lower 4's, or it could be just a lower incisor if it's not that severe. Or it could be, if it's severe class 3, it could be lower 4's only. If it's even more severe class 3, it could be lower 4's and put in some type of internal lower anchorage like a lingual arch until you've retracted your canines. How do you know what to do? That comes with experience. Just a quick little tip though, if you do have an iTero and if you are an Invisalign provider and if you do lots of cases already with Invisalign, first of all, I do premolar extraction cases all the time with Invisalign. It works out just fine, okay? No problems with that. But you can mock up the case and try it all. Their software is good. I mean, it's very sophisticated. I feel very confident when I mock up different options. You can try out with elastics, without elastics. You can try 5's versus 4's. I mean, obviously, they don't have the power to simulate the profile yet. So, I mean, that's something you just have to kind of visualize. That would be a cool additional add if they were able to mock up that, like they do with some of that oral surgery software. You can kind of see how the soft tissue will drape. I love that idea. That's really, really hard to visualize unless you've had the experience. But you can see how the mechanics would work if you took out 4's versus 5's, incisor versus bicuspids, blah, blah, blah. Really, really cool stuff. I love to do that just to play with it because in my mind, I often have an idea, but I'm not super confident, you know? I mean, it does come with experience, right? So that's pretty much it. 4's versus 5's. Hopefully that was helpful. Take care.